Hiya, I'm Eve. I work at Arts for Health. I do art therapy there. Welcome to another art therapy video. So we're doing a process today with fabric and sewing, exploring how it feels to put materials together using a needle and thread. But just so you know, you don't need to be a perfect sewer or anything like that. This is still an artwork and we're just doing an exploration with fabric. So you don't need to have a sewing machine or any amazing sewing skills or anything like that. More what we're doing is exploring the materials in the process and how they make us feel. All you need to have is a needle and thread and some fabric. Then we're going to make a response image at the end and I'll share my process with you. So our process today, step one, is to go and gather your fabric and your needle and thread. And then we're going to lay these fabrics out in front of us so we can start to explore them and see how they work together. So once you've laid your materials out and you're starting to explore them, so you might be touching them, seeing how the colours work together, seeing what the different fabrics look like, what patterns they have. As you're doing this exploration with your hands and your eyes, you're going to start to decide between whether you're going to make a quilt, so sewing pieces of fabric together. Are you going to make a bag, which would be sewing pieces on top of each other so you could put something inside them, or are you going to work a little bit more intuitively? So there are three options there. Those options just give us a little bit of structure if we would like it. All of these are great options and you can make a choice about which one you'd like to do once you've started to work with your fabric and get to know it a little bit. So the next step is to sew things together. So this is all about connecting things and modifying things, weaving them together. So notice how it feels to you. We want to especially notice what's it like to attach things together and to modify things. You might be feeling like it's very controlled and peaceful. It might be very creative and expressive and unknown to you. It might be very unpredictable, or it might be very pre-planned. So notice what that process of working with the fabric is like for you. Then after we've done our sewing process, we're going to take a pause and then move on to our response image. For our response image, we're using pastel or crayon. We're putting a piece of paper in front of us and we're making an image that responds back to what we've made with our fabric. So we might be responding to what we see. We might be responding to how it's made us feel in our body. We might be responding to something that we've remembered. So any of those things can go down into your pastel response image. Then we're going to take one more pause. Put the images side by side. So you've got your fabric artwork and your pastel artwork. You're going to put a title on each of them and notice what they look like when they're side by side. There might be some interesting story or sort of conversation between the two images. Then I'll come back and I'll be doing some sharing about mine. Okay, so materials that we need for today. Obviously the first thing is fabric. So fabric and also a needle and thread. So I have my sewing kit. But you don't need lots of different colours of thread unless you want to. Really, you just need one needle and one colour of thread and a pair of scissors. The other thing that we need is some pastel and crayon for our response image and a piece of paper to do that on. So that's what we need today. Let's get into it. Okay, so I have finished my sewing process and my pastel response image. So I have my fabric here. And here is my response image. So I use pastel and crayon together for this one. Okay, so just some reflection about my process making this quilt. What I did notice as I was going was that my energy was quite calmed down. It felt like everything was a little bit predictable and soft and nourishing. It reminded me of being some sort of mother in a tribe stitching things for the kids. So there was a kind of care and nourishment and community feeling. Even though this was just being made for me, it reminded me of lots of ideas of caring for others. So one of the ideas of the whole process is joining things together, but that really did stand out as quite a strong thing, all about the layers of the different colours and the stitches that join things. And it reminded me again, because of my thought about the community, that the stitches reminded me of the ways that we connect with each other. And then it was interesting also, I had a little part where I removed some stitches and changed it a little bit, and that was a very interesting modification time, where some of the stitches of connection were then changed and removed. So that was a very interesting thing for me to explore. There's something about valuing other people, probably because of the gold. It reminded me a little bit of royalty, or sort of the way you might care for someone else and show them a gift that has some value in it, just because of the shininess of the fabrics, really. The other thing that came into my mind as I was working with this is that there's lots of different stories all joined together as well. So where these fabrics have come from and who's made them and what's linked to the colours that are there, all those are different stories that I've just brought together. And that was a really beautiful thing for me to start to explore, and even a gift to me to be able to be the one that joined all these different stories together. It was a little bit like a privilege for me. There was a very practical sensory element with the fabric as well, so it was a little bit like problem solving or just working out what goes where, and it was very doable and practical that my mind could focus on physical things, stitching things together. It's like I didn't need a big plan, but I knew basically what was happening, and that was very comforting. There was also a slowness to the process, so that was comforting as well. We had some predictability, and I could just slowly go through and through and through with my needle and thread. And because of the nature of the fabric, it was also, everything felt very soft and comforting. So I felt quite powerful and safe and empowered, and I had soft, safe fabrics around me. So that was quite cool. Then in terms of my image, my response image, so what I worked with was the pastel and crayon. And I just went intuitively, responding to what I had in the fabric image right next to me, next to this piece of paper. So when I paused and did some reflection afterwards, all I could see was that there was a big splash here coming into a bit of a flatter area. So straight away I started to see something joining into something else. And there was kind of a feeling of this being safe and this being high energy. It was like a meeting of two different pieces, of a high energy piece and a soft nourishing piece, and those two coming together. And I felt like that connected with the idea of attaching things and the different connections in the fabric that I'd sewn together, and how beautiful it is when they meet together. There was also just a general softness and nourishment, so words about nourishment and the pink and the purple and the warm colours and the grey, they all reminded me of nourishment and safety and comfort and care, those ideas that came from the fabric. So there was this idea that the softness and the nourishment could contain and support and go next to the higher energy. So I really took that as a useful insight for myself in terms of sometimes having high energy and that being okay, and sometimes having soft, nourishing, calm energy and that being okay, and those two can come together. The final thing that I noticed was that there is quite a lot of different lines and different colours in this final image, and I think after I did the sewing, I felt enough comfort and safety and confidence that I could be quite expressive in this response image, and that it sort of gave me permission to splash out a little bit. So that's something that I saw in this image as well. So that's my process today. Okay, that's us for today. Thank you for watching. Come back and watch next week. Thank you.